So to make a to drive a point home, we also need to see the definition of repairs and alterations. And for definition of repairs and alterations, you do not go to the HTSUS, chapter 98, subchapter 2. You actually go to the Code of Federal Regulations here, section 18164. And section 18164 says that repairs and alterations means here's and they pretty much give you the buzzwords, and a lot of those buzzwords are most likely, if you are being tested, the customs examiners are likely to use those buzzwords. They will not imagine anything funny, although sometimes they can. But let's take a look. So the buzzwords are restoration, addition, renovation, redying, cleaning, restellarizing, so the medical supplies probably, and other treatment which does not destroy the essential characteristics or create newly commercially different good from the good that was exported from the United States. If this sounds familiar, you are probably right, because those are the concepts that dealt, although from the other side, in when we talked about concept of substantial transformation. So substantial transformation means new article of commerce. Here, it's the same side, but it requires, in order for repairs or alterations to qualify, it requires it to be fall short of that substantial transformation requirement. So next question kind of clarifies how this repairs and alteration concept is being tested on the exam, and it comes from the negative. But let's read the fact pattern. Let's read the whole thing, which says PhoneMex is planning to set up a telephone repair production facility in Mexico. PhoneMex will return all telephones and repaired or produced directly to the United States. So they're going to Mexico for repairs and alterations. Remember, warranty is irrelevant for Mexico, so let's continue reading. The return telephones are not entitled to duty-free entry as originating goods under NAFTA, but we do not need that. Recall that if we go to the chapter 9802, heading 9802, and we go to that note 3D, it clearly says that that whether or not such goods are of Canada or Mexico under the terms of General Note 12, meaning that no, you really do not need to engage in the Note 12 analysis. Although one can argue this is a part of the agreement, simply because if you look at the section 18164, which is under NAFTA, right, it really talks about repairs and alterations, the term that we saw in the outline, right? So it's kind of clumsy way, I would argue, to put it. We kind of see the point that customs examiners are trying to make, right? But in other words, it's clumsy because the section 18164 kind of codifies that chapter 9802 provisions for NAFTA. It's kind of like part of NAFTA, but it has its own separate treatment, separate set of rules. But with that in mind, let's read on. So, which PhoneMex operations would not qualify? So we're looking for the one that is not, as repairs or alterations entitling the return telephones to the duty-free treatment. So, all right, we know the buzzwords. We know that the requirement must the product, whatever is made, it must fall short of new article of commerce, of new product, and. So let's start out our analysis from A. fully functional used telephones would be exported from the United States to Mexico, where they would be modified slightly by adding a redial capability. All right, so no new telephone emerged, only slight modification, no new article of commerce, so this is fine. A fits 9802 criteria, and again, we're looking for the one that's not. So moving further. B, telephone subassemblies would be exported from the United States to Mexico for assembly into completed telephones. All right, here you have telephone parts. Telephone parts would go to Mexico and they would become completed product, right? So B is kind of questionable because you have subassemblies, you have parts, and you have the operation, even though it's an assembly operation. If the assembly operation is complicated enough, then it would qualify as the substantial transformation. So the simple assembly operations, of course, do not qualify. So if you're just riveting the screws, that will not do. But it looks like subassemblies dealing with the telephones. Telephone is a high technologically relatively high-tech equipment. So we may deal with the concept of substantial transformation. Also, looking at the buzzwords, restoration, addition, renovation, redying, cleaning, restellarizing, other treatment, most likely if none of the buzzwords are applicable, addition may be applicable, right? But here the focus is on the change in essential character, and the point B does kind of indicate that from parts you're going to be bringing back the whole working units, and the whole working units is just too far out because it does look like a new article of commerce ready to use telephone sets. So B, I wouldn't eliminate it right away. I would put a question mark because the concept of substantial transformation is tricky. It's kind of fluid and it's subjective. So here, this is in this particular example, this example is a good example of analytical perspective through the process of elimination, right? So we eliminated A because we knew that there was this buzzword slide, right? It signals to us no substantial transformation. Here there's no such thing, so we put a question mark and read on. Non-functional used telephones would be exported to the United States from the U.S. to Mexico, where they would be restored to their original condition. So here you have telephones. Although they are non-functional, they are still complete units. Here you have incomplete units, you have parts. But here you have a complete unit, and all was going to be done to them is the repair. The essential character of the telephone does not change. The end use does not change. The product itself does not change. It's just being repaired. So C looks like in line with A is not our choice because C provides for something which does fit that repair or alteration clause. D, black and beige telephones would be exported from the United States to Mexico for repairing in more popular colors. So this is explicitly provided in the buzzword choice because we have redying, right? Redying or changing the color is something which is mere repair or alteration. So B is obviously not our answer choice because D is obviously not our answer choice because this is just mere alteration, if you will. And lastly, E, telephones having defective or unacceptable ringtones will be exported from Mexico to Mexico from United States to install inexpensive, more pleasant and appealing sounding device. All right. So here all has been changed. The sound is again, it's in a line of slight modification provisions. It's not changing the essential character. The reason you buy a phone is to communicate, it's not to play music, even if it plays music like many smartphones do currently nowadays, still doesn't change the essential character. So E is also not our choice. So with this in mind, we can be more certain to pick for B as a correct answer choice by eliminating all the other ones that stand out on the side of repairs or alterations as opposed to the side of changing essential character. So for this one, B is a correct answer choice.